citywide second quarter, with an increase of 20 murders, 33 versus 13, with no singular defining motive. However, notably, stabbing murders were up 11 versus 1 in the Bronx, and domestics were up 5 versus 0. We made tremendous adjustments going to the third quarter to address the homicides and gang violence citywide and specifically in the Bronx. We deployed summer all-out heavily in the Bronx. We increased the ceasefire catchment area to include the 4-6 and 5-2 precincts, in addition to the existing catchment areas of the 4-0 precinct and PSA 7, which covers housing in the South Bronx. We worked closely with our partners in parole and probation to add geographical and curfew restrictions on gang and crew members to prevent retaliatory violence. And these weren't just one-size-fits-all steps. A perfect example is the citywide Trinitario enforcement action, which prevented parolees and probationers from attending certain events like Dominican Day Parade. And we continue to work closely with prosecutors to enhance all gun prosecutions. These measures have brought the Bronx murder down, the Bronx murder number down significantly in the third quarter, 18 versus 26. That's a decrease of 8. Year to date, the Bronx is still showing an increase of 14 murders, 66 versus 52. The Bronx increase of 14 may be hard to overcome by the end of the year, but their shootings are down 31 year to date and down 5 shootings in September from 25 to 20, which is an unbelievable reduction in gun violence in the Bronx. In the third quarter, as the Bronx was trending down overall, Queens was 20 versus 18, but specifically, Queens North saw an increase of 10 murders versus 3. We saw two domestic violence tragedies that took 4 lives and 2 additional murders, giving the 114 precinct 6 versus 1 in the third quarter. Again, through analysis and redeployment, we are seeing significant reductions in violence in those areas.